Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to make this lotus flower ring. It's an intermediate design. If you want to see my start to finish process, stay tuned. Okay, I'm using 18 gauge round dead soft copper wire, and this is a little over 12 inches long. To start my first petal, I'm going to bend this right in the middle. And then I'll just pull it apart and start shaping my petal. Now I can begin shaping my next petal. And following that same pattern, I'm going to make three more petals so that I have five total. Okay, now we can weave these petals together and add a bead. I'm using 28 gauge weaving wire, and it's about 20 inches long, and I'm just going to be coiling it twice on each side, and I'll add some freeze frames to show you the weave as it progresses. Thank you. I'm adding a tiny 2 millimeter faceted pink tourmaline bead, and I'm going to hold it gently while I tie the weaving wire to my petals. And now I'll do just a couple more weaves before bending these wires. And using some flat nose pliers, I'm just going to bend these at 90 degrees. And then I'll finish off this weaving wire with a few coils onto the back petal here so that it's kind of hidden from the front. All right, now we can begin shaping our ring on our mandrel. Okay, to tie the shank of our ring closed, I'm using 22 gauge half round wire. If you don't have half round, you can use 28 or 26 gauge weaving wire, but I just prefer how smooth the half round is when snipping it off and tucking it into the ring. I feel like it's less likely to snag on clothing and stuff. But if you only have 28 or 26 gauge wire, that's okay. Just make sure that you tuck it in really well so that it doesn't snag. So I'm just wrapping this together with a couple of coils with the flat side down against my 18 gauge wire. Now we can put the ring back on the mandrel and finish closing it from each side. And doing this on the mandrel will help keep us from pulling these too tight and making them uneven and shrinking the ring size down. We want to make sure to file and smooth these ends of the wire before closing them. I'm just using a metal file and some 1500 grit sandpaper, and this is just going to make sure that these wires don't scrape or scratch anybody while they're being worn. And we just want to bend the tips of these petals ever so slightly so the ring doesn't catch on clothing while it's being worn. And now we can oxidize and polish. Okay guys, here's our finished lotus flower ring. I'd like to give a shout out to Lan An Handmade because I learned this basic lotus pattern from one of her videos a long time ago. I've added some things to make it my own, but she definitely gets credit for the initial inspiration. Here's another one I made with smaller petals. Some ways you can alter this design are by using different shaped beads. You can use square wire instead of round. You can even do some weaving on the shank if you like. Lots of ways to make this your own. Alright guys, thanks so much for joining me today. I really hope you enjoyed this project. Let me know what you think in the comments. If you'd like to help me make more of these tutorials, please hit the like button and consider sharing on your social media because that's really what helps my channel grow. And don't forget to subscribe and tap the bell so you get notified every time I upload a new video. Also, if you follow me on Instagram, feel free to share pictures of your creations with me. I love to see what my tutorials inspire. I'm also on TikTok now, so you can follow me on there as well. I just want to end by saying have a fantastic day and remember to love your neighbor as yourself, and in all things, treat others as you want to be treated, for this is the law and the prophets. God bless you guys, and I hope to see you in the next video.